You're watching UNICEF Television.
Za'atari refugee camp, northern Jordan. This bleak desert camp is now home to over 90,000 Syrians. More than half are children. 13-year-old Bashir is one of them. His family fled their home 7 months ago. But since arriving, his thoughts have never left his hometown of Dera.
Living here in Za'atari camp, thank God, it's okay, but in Syria it's better. I don't want anything. I just want to go back to our home country.
Bashir's family were early arrivals at the camp and are one of the lucky few who have since moved from a fragile tent to a prefabricated unit.
This is the outside area of the house. This is the room where we keep our belongings. And this is my younger brother. And here's the caravan. This is the kitchen where we do our cooking.
This single room is what the family must now call home, both in the current chill of winter and in the searing heat of the summer to come. Bashir attends the camp's UNICEF-supported school. Through classes like these, the school tries to bring some degree of normality to thousands of children as they deal with the horrors they have been through.
I like to go to school because of the education and I like to learn English. I am continuing here so that I will not miss out on my education. When we go back to Syria, I will continue my education and I will be successful in the future.
When he's not studying, Bashir spends time at one of the camp's youth centers. These help children and young people to re-engage with their childhood and relearn social skills. Meanwhile, his father, Nabil, tries to make ends meet by selling falafel sandwiches at a stall on the camp's main road. With no other income, the cash he raises helps to support the family.
I miss everything in Dera. The town is what I miss most.
With up to 3,000 refugees flooding into Jordan every day, UNICEF and its partners are faced with a huge task to provide clean and safe water, education, and health and child protection to the ever-growing numbers. Yet less than 20% of the required funds have been raised. With such a massive shortfall, the task of preventing Bashir and the children of Syria becoming part of a lost generation is even more of a challenge. This is Toby Fricker reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, please go to unicef.org.
You've been watching UNICEF Television.